What's up, Achievers?
How's it going?
Lauren here.
Jason.
I guess you know us by now. But anyway, we've got a 45-minute dumbbell workout for you. It's going to be strength-focused with a little cardio at the end. Jason said this one's a glute killer.
Glute emphasis. A lot of people requested glutes last time, so we're going to do total body, but with a little bit of glute emphasis, all right?
Hope you're excited. I'm going to demonstrate with two dumbbells. Jason's going to demonstrate with one. So depending on what you have at home, you can choose what suits you best. And let's go ahead and get started with the warm-up.
All right, cool. So we're going to start standing. I want you to get started with your feet shoulder-width apart. You're going to bend your knees a little bit. And then from there, you're going to send your hips way back into a hinge while allowing your chest to lean forward. Okay, so this is just a bodyweight hinge pattern. And then I want you to stand up tall, squeeze your glutes, squeeze your abs. And then we're going to bring it back down. So bend your knees a little bit. Sit your hips back, torso leans forward, and then you stand up tall. All right, let's keep on going at your own pace. And right after these, we're gonna do some bodyweight squats. And what you'll notice the difference is your hips are staying pretty up high towards the ceiling as you sit back. And when we squat in a little bit, we're gonna be sending our hips down. So that's gonna be the difference, all right? So we wanna hinge when we do deadlifts, and we wanna squat obviously when we're doing squats. All right, and stand up tall. Okay, so shake it out. I'll face you this time this way. Feet about shoulder width apart again. Feet flared out a little bit. You're gonna squat yourself down, push your knees out to the sides, and then stand up tall, squeeze your glutes, squeeze your legs and quads, okay? Perfect. So important thing to think about here is really push your knees out to the sides because you wanna try to drop down in between your thighs. What you don't want to do and want to avoid is having your feet hip width apart because then you end up kind of blocking yourself. All right, so make sure you get those knees out wide. Get a good solid wide stance. We're gonna get one more here. Awesome. Okay, now from there, we're gonna go into what we call an inchworm. I'm gonna have you get your feet about hip width apart. And from there, you're gonna come down, try to touch your toes, get down to the floor, touch the ground, walk your way out in small steps into a push-up position, and then we're gonna bring it back. And then stand up tall, okay? If you need to bend your knees, feel free to do that. Come down, touch the floor, small steps, get into a push-up position, and then bring it back. Good, we got a couple more. Just warming up those shoulders, warming up hamstrings, calves, and your back a little bit. Perfect, we're gonna do one more. Making sure, as you walk out, to try to keep your hips square, so you're not swaying too much from side to side. Okay, awesome. We're gonna come down one more time and then get into a Spider-Man lunge. So I want you to get your left foot forward as close to the outside of your left hand as you can. And then from there, you're gonna drop your left forearm towards the floor and reach that arm up towards the ceiling. You're gonna bring that hand back, bring the foot back, and switch sides. So right foot forward, drop that right forearm towards the floor, and reach that arm up towards the ceiling. Bring the hand back, bring the foot back, and keep going side by side. Side to side, rather.
We're side by side.
And keep switching.
Doing this makes me look at my nails, and I painted my nails for the first time in the pandemic, 3 or 4 days ago. And literally, so it's been a year since my nails have had polish on them, and Jason noticed yesterday.
I'm actually usually pretty good at
That's true.
Yeah. But nails, yeah. All right, cool. So we're all done with the warm-up there. We got our hinges, our squats, and our whole body prepared. Lauren, take it away with circuit number one.
All right, great. So circuit number one, we're going to do four moves. It's going to be four rounds, and the time interval is going to be 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. So this will be our longest working set. All right, we're gonna start with an RDL. So this is a Romanian deadlift, very similar to the pattern we just warmed up with the hinge. You're gonna have, if you have two dumbbells, you're gonna hold them out in front of you. You're gonna have that soft bend in your knees and then send those hips back, tracing your legs down with the weights and then standing up tall. And like Jason's showing, if you have one weight, you're gonna hold the outsides of the handles and do the RDL the same way. All right, then we're gonna go into a glute bridge floor press. So for this one, you're gonna lay on your back. If you have the two dumbbells, you're gonna hold one in each hand. If you have one dumbbell, you're gonna hold the outsides again. You're going to start by pinning your shoulders down and back, squeezing your shoulder blades. Then you're gonna drive your heels into the floor, bridge your hips up. So you start in this glute bridge position. And then from here, you're gonna press your weights straight up to the ceiling and then lower them back down. Elbows to the floor and up. All right, challenge here is gonna be to keep those glutes high. You're gonna be tempted to let them start to sink down. You wanna keep them high the whole time. So we're maintaining that glute bridge position throughout the set. Oh, did you, you're good?
Yep.
I was like, am I supposed to be telling them more about what you're doing? So if you're holding the one dumbbell, just holding it by the outsides, your elbows will be a little tighter to your body that way. Then we're gonna go into a half kneeling dead start row. For this one, you only need one dumbbell, whether you've been using two or one previously. You're gonna get in this half kneeling position, elbow on your front knee. You're gonna let that back hip drop down. So you have some extension here, squeezing that glute. And then from there, you're gonna grab the dumbbell, row up toward your hip, pull that shoulder back, and lower it down toward the floor. All right, beautiful. What we're gonna do here is we're actually gonna do the left arm for the full round, for full 40 seconds, and then the next following circuit, we'll do the other side. So the next two exercises, we're gonna do just single-sided, and then round two, we'll do the other side. Round three, we'll go back to the first side. Round four, we'll do the second side. The last one is a bent knee side plank with hip abduction. So you're gonna be getting onto your forearm, stacking one knee over the other. You can have your hand on your hip or up to the ceiling, whatever feels better. You're gonna go into that kneeling side plank position, so hips are forward and up, and then we're gonna bring that knee up and back down. So it's like a clamshell if you've done those before, just going up and down, trying to feel the outside of that glute, that top glute, working hard as you bring that knee up. Cool?
Cool.
Sound good? Everybody ready? Let's do it. So we're gonna start with the RDL. So if you have your two weights, you're grabbing one in each hand. If you have your one weight, you're grabbing the outsides of the dumbbell. We're gonna start in 5 seconds. Yeah, three, two, one, let's go. So we're softening those knees, sending the hips back, pushing into the floor, standing tall. We really wanna think about, like Jason was saying in the warm-up, not squatting these. So we're keeping our hips high, sending them back. And then driving your feet hard into the floor, squeezing your glutes and your legs at the top, so you're fully locking everything out. All right, we also wanna think about being active with our upper body or upper back. So think about making sure that you're not allowing your shoulders to round forward or your chest to cave. Open everything up. Nice job, we got 5 more seconds here. Should be feeling the backs of those legs. 2, 1, and rest. Very good. We're gonna go down onto our backs. You can stagger a little bit here. And we're gonna do that glute bridge with the chest press. All right, so get yourselves set up. We got 10 seconds to start. Down onto your back. Drive those heels into the floor. Pinch the shoulders back. 3, 2, 1, and go. So we're bridging those hips, keeping them high the whole time as we press. If you're using the two dumbbells, you're gonna get a little bit of a rotation. So at the bottom, you rotate your hands in slightly, elbows are about 45 degrees from your body, and then press up and rotate those hands forward. Beautiful. All right, you should feel those glutes working hard to keep your hips up. If you notice yourself starting to sink down, drive those heels a little harder. Awesome work, we got 10 more seconds here. Keep those shoulders pinned back at the bottom. 3, 2, 1,
oof,
and rest.
That builds up.
All right, Jason was lying about the glutes. All right, next we've got our half kneeling row, so you can put one dumbbell off to the side. Let's go right leg forward, so your left hand is rowing the weight. We've got 3, 2, 1, and go. So your back hip is extended slightly, thinking about squeezing that back glute, and then really pull with your upper back, squeezing at the top, pulling that shoulder back. Awesome work, just a nice different angle for a row than you might be used to. We're halfway there. 40 seconds on one side is gonna start to get heavy. Make sure that you're not rushing through these. This is our strength segment. We're trying to think about form and mindfulness, not about rushing. We got 3, 2, 1, and rest.
Oof.
Awesome. All right, now my right arm is like craving to do a set, but we'll get there, we'll get there. We're gonna go down to the floor, or stay down on the floor. We're doing our side plank with hip abduction. Which side are you going?
Let's go left side
left
first.
Left side, all right. 3, 2, 1, and go. So bring that knee up and down. Think about squeezing those glutes the whole time. You wanna think about your head and your tailbone making one straight line, so we don't wanna be crunched forward. Everything's nice and pulled back. Pressing with that bottom forearm into the floor to keep your shoulder in a nice stable position here. Nice job, we got 15 more seconds. These add up as well. Awesome work. 5 more seconds, keep it going, really squeeze at the top. 2, 1, whew. And rest.
All left right. Side sufficiently worked right now.
Definitely. I like sticking with everything on the left, and then we'll switch it up.
Evening it out.
All right, Jason's going to lead you through round 2.
All right, back to Romanian deadlifts. Grab your dumbbell or dumbbells. We're going to get started in 3 seconds. 2, 1, and begin. Again, making sure you stand up tall. Squeeze your glutes. Squeeze your abs at the top. Make sure knees are just soft at the bottom, but they shouldn't really travel forward or back. They should kind of just stay where they are. We don't want to turn this into more of a squatty movement. You got about 15 more seconds left. And again, stand tall at the top of each one. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Got a frog in my throat there.
Jason's right. Had a frog. It's been living in his throat
for a perennial frog.
Several months.
Always happens right before podcasts, before YouTube videos. All right, we got our glute bridge floor press coming up. In 3, 2, 1, and go. So bridge up and then press away. The whole time thinking about glutes and abs engaged. And what you'll notice is that while a standard glute bridge might not be challenging, having it come right after Romanian deadlift and kind of pre-fatiguing your hamstrings and your glutes makes that glute bridge even more challenging, especially after the end of this 40-second set and throwing in a chest press on top of it. Lauren, how much time is left?
5 seconds.
All right, 3, 2, 1. Awesome work. Rest it up 20 seconds. And then we've got our half kneeling deadstart rows. We're gonna balance it out. We're gonna row on the right side this time. Left knee is forward. In 10 seconds. All right, get ready. And 3, 2, 1, and go. So the tendency here is going to be to round your chest forward and kind of hunch forward and really lean into that leg. But do your best to keep that chest up tall, making sure your upper back is arched a little bit. And that leads to just better posture overall. Perfect. Squeeze that back leg glute, that right leg. And so you get a little bit of a dual benefit here because the front leg, that glute, is really working to stabilize you. And the back leg, the hip flexor is being stretched and the glute is being engaged. So we got a lot of indirect glute work happening right after that Romanian deadlift.
1, rest.
Awesome.
Oh.
Cool. Right side now on the kneeling side plank hip abductions. We're gonna go on in 10 seconds. I'm just gonna stand to kind of shake things out a little bit.
That's a good idea. I'm gonna sit and collapse into the floor.
All right, in 3, 2, 1, and go. So kneeling side plank, and then feet are together as you do this sort of clamshell movement. Now, if you happen to have a band, feel free to wrap it around the knees for the next 2 rounds coming up if you want to make it a little bit more intense.
If you're a masochist.
Or you can also go with this sort of dip into an abduction this way to get even more of a burn. All right, so
yeah, you demonstrate
the world's
that.
Your oyster.
I'm going to stick right here.
10 more seconds. But either way, you should still feel the side of your glutes, your obliques, and a little bit of this top glute as well. And time, good. We're halfway there.
Whew. Awesome work. Yeah, on those, I always expect to feel the top glute more, but it's always the bottom glute
always the
that
bottom
gets
one. The support.
It's true.
10 seconds.
All right, we're going back to our RDLs. We're halfway through the circuit. Grab your dumbbells or dumbbell. In 3, 2,
should we face forward?
1. Let's do
and
it. Let's
go.
Face forward. All right, just giving you a different perspective here.
It also helps for this one to get your knees slightly pushed out to the sides. It helps you just hinge back a little bit easier and maintain your base a little bit better.
Very true. Also, you want to make sure that you're stopping yourself wherever you feel, whenever you feel that you can't keep sending your hips back. So basically, if you get to this point and you feel like the only way to get lower is to round your upper back, then that's the point you stop at. All right, so you want to just go until you can no longer send your hips back any further, and then stand up. We got 3, 2, 1,
Ooh,
and rest.
Okay.
Awesome.
Feeling it.
Definitely feeling it.
Glute bridge floor press coming up.
All right, on these, really focus on those shoulders, getting them down and back and squeezed at the bottom so that your shoulders aren't rounding forward as you bring the weights down. We got 3, 2, 1, and go. Driving those hips up. Jason mentioned this in the last round, but make sure that your rib cage is down. We don't want to have a big arch in our back, so we're not driving our hips up so high that we're arching hard. We want ribs down, hips up. And that combination is going to engage your abs and your glutes together, which is always better.
And if you do it properly, your hips might drop a little bit, and that's okay, as long as you feel glutes and abs engaged the whole time.
Yeah, another thing you can do is play around with your foot position. So if you're not feeling your glutes, maybe turn your toes out slightly, maybe push your knees out a little more. Play around with your positioning to find a place that you feel it. And rest.
Oof, okay.
All right, we're back to the left arm for our rows. Jason, are you hitting the floor with the row, or are you hovering?
I am hovering.
Me too.
I'm hovering, yeah.
Just double checking.
But if you have a heavy enough dumbbell, you'll definitely be hitting the floor most likely.
Three, two, one, and go. That's true, dumbbell shapes. I mean, dumbbells come in all shapes and sizes.
So really pulling that shoulder blade back and down at the top of each rep. Really getting your back involved here. Upper and mid back.
Awesome, halfway there. Keep going on this side. Squeeze at the top. Remember, you can always slow those reps down if it's starting to get heavy, but make each individual rep really count. Try to get that full range of motion with each Ooh. One. 5 more seconds, you got it. 2, 1, and
All right.
rest. Awesome work. We'll go left side, side plank.
Oh, I almost switched sides in the row.
Oh.
All the blood rushing away from my head.
10 seconds to get started. I'm gonna do the dippy one.
The dippy one? Okay.
I'm gonna do it.
All right, let's do it. We'll showcase that one.
3, 2, 1, let's
go.
And go. So you start down on the floor and then go forward and up. It feels almost like it should be easier because you get that break on the floor, but it's totally not.
But it's not. And my left side is way worse than my right side.
Well, I'm glad I made you do this side. I'm just working on your imbalances. Halfway there.
I'm gonna get one more. And then go back to the baseline variation.
Cool, and that's something that you could definitely do. No worries if you want to try out something new, something a little more advanced. Doing it for 40 seconds might be too long, so you can do it for half, and then move back to the original.
Oh boy.
Variation. Oh my goodness. And rest. Yeah, that was so much harder.
Okay.
I had to do it though. Okay, because we're so close. We have one more round.
Whew.
We're back to our RDLs. Round 4. This is our longest circuit. You're gonna feel so, everything's gonna move so fast after this.
We got this, we got this.
All right, we got 3, 2, 1, let's go. Nice job. This round, think about what your upper back is doing. Think about making sure your shoulders are staying connected to your body, not getting away from you. Think about where the dumbbell is as well, making sure it's staying close to your body as opposed to floating out in front of you. Nice job. 15 more seconds here. Keep going strong. Use the backs of your legs to stand up tall. Awesome work. 5 seconds to go. And rest. Nice.
All right.
I feel like this is one of those where, like, I don't know, for the RDLs for me, I don't feel it that much in the moment. Like, I feel it, but it's tomorrow.
Yeah.
You're going to be like, oh my goodness. What did I do to my hamstrings?
It's definitely the combination of stretching and strengthening that can really get that soreness in. All right, 3, 2, 1, and bridge. Not much else to say. This one's pretty straightforward.
We're just going to meditate for this one. I hope you're in. Awesome. If you've seen Queen's Gambit, start to picture chess on the ceiling as you're doing this. I don't know anything about it, so I'm just picturing the pieces, and I don't know how they move.
Yeah, we took some tranquilizer pills before this, so.
Jason was bragging about his pre-workout that he gets to take before these that pumps him up, and I have to drink decaf coffee because I'm pregnant. 3, 2, 1.
Oof.
Such an unfair advantage in so many ways. All right, we're going to our row. I don't know why I stood up. I just needed a break, I guess. I was getting amped up from my
All right, in 10 seconds.
Whew.
All right, right side.
3, 2, 1. Let's
and go.
Jason's pre-workout routine today consisted of a pre-workout drink and cinnamon toast crunch. It was a pretty good combo.
Get some caffeine, got some carbs, ready to go. All right, we're about halfway there. Whew.
Mine was a bacon Gouda breakfast sandwich from Starbucks, which basically got me through my whole pregnancy last time, so I don't want to mess with anything. I'm just going to keep going. It's worked for me so far.
5 seconds. Oh,
Three,
boy.
3, 2, 1, and rest. Awesome.
All right.
We got to do the hip dips.
At least for half
to match yourself on the other side. 10 seconds to go. All right, here we go. In 3, 2, 1, let's do it.
Nice, looking good. You know, one interesting thing that I've been seeing on YouTube are, you know, workouts like these, but it's no repeated movements. And I think that's super interesting. We want to repeat movements because we want to get practice in with all these different patterns and get a lot of reps in so we continue to get better. If you're constantly not repeating exercises, you never end up getting better. You're constantly just doing something brand new and novel, and so you never progress in that movement. So that's the reason why we like to do these movements and do them for multiple rounds in a row. So if you ever wonder why,
rest.
That's why we repeat.
Oh, high five.
My right side is way stronger, at least in that movement, than the left one.
And you'll notice that, yeah. There's gonna be definite, when you do single-sided movements, you're gonna see some asymmetries pop up. If it's not a time-based workout, if you're just doing it for reps, you can always add a couple reps or two on the side that feels a little bit, quote-unquote, weaker.
Yeah, it also helps to start on that side, too. Start on that side too, when you're fresher, and then match it on the other side so you're not developing even more of an imbalance.
Such a good point.
Cool. All right, circuit number 2, I will give you the general lowdown, and then Lauren will go over the exercises, but it's going to be 30 seconds on, 15 seconds off, 3 rounds total with 4 different movements. All
three
right?
Different movements.
3 different movements. All right, Lauren, you want to take it away with
yes.
the exercises?
So for this one, you are only going to need a single dumbbell for all of the moves. So we'll show you, we'll both be showing you with a single bell. We're going to do, instead of doing alternating sides from circuit to circuit, we're gonna do one move, but 2 different sides for each round. So the first round is gonna be a split squat to overhead press on the right side. So you're gonna have your left foot forward with your right hand holding the dumbbell. You're in this split stance position. You're gonna bring your back knee down to the floor and then press overhead and then pull it back down and press. So we're gonna do that for 30 seconds on that side. Then we'll shake it out. Round 2, we're gonna go to the other side. So you bring your left hand to your left shoulder, drop that knee down, and press. All right, so that's gonna be exercise 1 and exercise 2. And then exercise 3 is gonna be a frog pump. So you can do this with or without the weight. I'll show you with the weight. You're gonna have your feet together and your knees out. All right, Jason, you're gonna show it body weight. Mm-hmm. So body weight, you're just gonna press your heels toward each other, press your hips up to the ceiling, and lower back down. Beautiful. If you're doing it with the weight, you can place the weight right on your hips and then do the same thing. Drive up, squeeze the glutes, and lower back down. So you're just adding a little bit of weight to make that movement a little bit more challenging. All right, you're gonna get a lot of glute there, especially after doing 2 sets of split squats on each side.
All right,
sound
this
good?
One's gonna be sneaky. It's gonna burn quite a bit.
It's gonna be sneaky, but it's gonna be pretty quick, especially in comparison to round 1. All right, so let's get yourself set up on your right side. 3 seconds. 2, 1,
let's go.
And go. Sorry, I got a little ahead of myself. Awesome. Think about dropping that back knee straight down and then driving up, using your legs to help with that overhead press. Awesome.
Now this is a little bit difficult to balance. If you have like a couch nearby or some sort of table, you can feel free to assist yourself with your balance there.
Don't grab your neighbor. That's what Jason does to me ice skating. It never ends up well. Two, one, and rest. We're like both not good at ice skating, so the fact that Jason grabs onto me is not a good
strategy. No, Lauren's pretty good. Lauren's pretty good, but for me, it's definitely like a big tree fall hard kind of thing. You definitely want to stay clear.
Two, one, let's go on the other side. I'm doing the same leg still. So you should have your opposite leg and arm forward. So your right leg is forward, holding the dumbbell in your left hand.
Oh boy, I'm feeling it now.
Yeah.
You'll notice my free hand, both of our free hands are out to the side to counterbalance. Well, it's tough to talk and balance throughout this. 5 seconds. Two, one, and good. Oh boy. But yeah, feel free to have this hand out to the side so you can kind of counterbalance as you're going through that movement. All right, frog pumps in 7 seconds.
You show the weighted one.
Oh boy, okay. Okay, two, one, and go. So glutes and abs engaged. Now the reason why the knees are out here is because your glutes are responsible for external rotation. External rotation basically just means that your hips and your knees are moving out to the sides. So by already having them out to the sides, it kind of facilitates the glutes, and you should feel it a fair amount as you're doing these bridges.
Three, two, one, rest. Ooh. Awesome. All right.
All right.
One round down, only two to go. This one, like I said, it moves nice and quick, so it burns, but it feels really good, and it moves fast. We're going back to our lunge to press, holding the weight in your right hand. Turn to the side this time, two, one, and go.
Which side's pressing?
What? I did it wrong again. Oh my goodness. Right leg forward, left arm pressing.
There's a mirror in front of me right here, and I was looking back at Lauren, and I got so confused. So I'm trying to mirror what I think is the right side.
Nice job. Almost there. 5 more seconds. Three. Two,
I'm tapping out.
One. Oh, you quit on me. All right, we're switching sides. Whew. So now we're holding it in our right hand with our left leg forward. In three, two, one, and go. Whew. Now we've been joking around about how this is hard to balance, but it really is. And if you're having a really hard time and you feel too wobbly, go ahead and just drop yourself down into a half kneeling position here, and you can do your presses from this kneeling position instead of worrying about the up and down.
Yep.
10 more seconds. Or if you're focusing on this glute workout, you can just do the lunge and skip the press.
Oh boy.
Either way, rest. Let's get into our frog pumps.
Oh God. In 10 seconds.
We got this.
The weight was light-ish for Romanian deadlifts, but it's pretty heavy for those split squat presses.
Yeah.
One, and go.
Nice job. It helps here to think about tilting your tailbone under and then going into the movement. Again, like Jason was saying with the glute bridge, it might make you feel like you can't go as high. If you arched your back, you could go higher, but the point isn't to arch your back. The point is to engage your glutes, and it actually helps to tilt under and then lift. You're gonna get a little more glute engagement there. 5 seconds here. Two, one, rest.
All right, one more.
Okay,
just one more. We can do one more.
Of course we can.
Eight seconds. Face forward.
Let's face forward.
Okay, I think that was easier. Three, two, one, and go. Ooh, that was seamless.
We're so synchronized now. Basically, I just have to stare at the same spot. That keeps me on track. Awesome work, everybody. Halfway there.
Looking good.
Keep it going. Use those legs to help with that press.
Oh boy, I'm shaking. My legs are shaking. 7 seconds.
You can do it. All the way through the buzzer, Jason. Come on. Two, one. Nice job.
All right.
Let's go. 10 seconds till the other side. We can do this. Switch your legs, switch your arms into position. three, two, one, let's go.
One of our bucket list items is to be on the Amazing Race together. So anytime we're doing any sort of task, if we want to get on the same page, we just start
yelling, Amazing Race!
Amazing Race, Amazing Race. And it makes us work together better, makes us push through a little bit harder, keeps our eye on the prize.
This is a couple tips.
Yeah.
It helps especially when you're wrangling.
Amazing Race.
Come on, two, one, rest. Nice job.
Oh boy.
Yeah, it works for everything. It works for lifting, it works for
IKEA
getting
furniture.
A toddler out of the house, IKEA furniture, anything. All right, come on. Three, two, one, let's go. Last set of frog pumps here. At least your shoulders get to rest.
Very true. My legs are dying though.
Are they?
Yep.
My shoulders hurt worse. Curious what you're feeling at home.
I thought you were saying that your shoulders hurt worse than my legs dying.
No.
You're like, really?
It's not
my
a competition.
My shoulders hurt worse.
Worse than my legs. 5 seconds, come on. Two, one.
Okay.
And rest.
All
awesome.
Right. High five.
High five.
We didn't high five last
to you.
Time.
I know.
High five, high five, high five.
We high fived.
Huh?
We high fived.
After circuit number one?
Sure
no,
did.
No, we were chatting.
No.
I'm gonna
reverse
replay
the tape, rest.
That's why we repeat.
Oh, high five.
My right side.
We definitely did.
All right, circuit number three. It's gonna be quick. Lightning round. 20 seconds off.
No.
20 seconds on. 10 seconds off. By three rounds, we've got two exercises. Lauren, drop that beat.
All right, we're gonna go pop out to squat. So you're gonna start with your feet in together. You're gonna pop them out into a squat position, drop down, and then pop them back into the middle. Now we're just gonna do that on repeat. So you're thinking about staying light on your feet and going nice and quick. All right, you can swing your arms, you can keep them in, whatever feels like it gets you into a rhythm, all right?
If you feel like you can't jump, either because you have neighbors downstairs or maybe your knees are a little bit iffy, feel free to just do speed squats instead.
Perfect. Then we're gonna do a dumbbell swing. So you're gonna grab your dumbbell. We have a couple different ways you can do this. You can go hand over hand like this or one hand in front of the other, depending on how small or big your hands are. And you can send that dumbbell back between your legs and swing so that it goes straight out in front of you. Or you can do this single arm. And you can switch, well, we only have three rounds. I guess let's just do a double arm.
Double arm, double arm.
Just do a double arm.
You like only I have said, one option.
You only have one option. If you're not comfortable with swings for any reason, you can do another RDL, so holding it on the outside. And this time, just thinking about doing it quickly. So instead of going for form and, well, you're still going for form, but instead of slowing it down and focusing on strength, you can make it a little bit more dynamic.
All right.
Sound good?
We're good, ready to rock.
You ready? This
yep.
one's gonna be over.
A little
in
breeze
a flash.
By. I All already right. feel my glutes just standing up.
I know. We're gonna start in 5 seconds. Pop out to squat or speed squat. Three, two, one, let's go. Oh, you do the reach forward, see? You do whatever works for you. Then everybody gets something a little different from their upper body that helps them feel like they can just go one right into the next.
What are you talking about?
Rest. I'm just talking my way through this so I don't feel my legs. All right, let's go into dumbbell swings. So either hand over hand or one hand in front of the other or an RDL into one. Let's go. Really working the backs of those legs, squeezing the glutes at the top. Send that weight straight out in front of you. Keep it up high in the backswing so it's right between your legs, above your knees. 5 seconds, come on. And rest.
All right.
Awesome. All right, one down, two to go.
Whew.
You know Jason wrote this because the finisher is as quick as it possibly could be. Two, one, and go.
Whew.
Nice
Me
job.
Me and finishers do not get along. I prefer lots of rest, heavier weights. But this is getting me out of my comfort zone. As I think about the Amazing Race.
Three, two, one. Shake them out. Come on.
All right.
We got this.
All right.
You ready for your swings? It's a really quick rest. Three, two, one. Let's go.
Whew.
We're focusing on hinging those hips, keeping them high and sending them back.
Legs, glutes.
Come
we got
on,
this.
Legs.
Come on. Come on.
5 more seconds. 2, 1. Okay, right. One more round.
One more.
Oh my God, I feel my hair just like
we got
expanding.
It. We got it. Woo.
3, 2, 1. Here we go.
Oh boy.
Come on. And don't short that squat. Get all the way down there. Come on. Whew. I know you want to avoid that temptation all the way down.
Legs are heavy. Come on, keep pushing.
Mom spaghetti.
3, 2, 1.
Is that part of the song?
Yep. That was a lose yourself preference, by Lauren.
All right, come on. 3,
oh my God.
2, 1. Let's go. I think it's knees weak. Arms are heavy.
Yeah, there you go.
Mom spaghetti. But it was close. Come on, 10 more seconds. Last set of swings here. We got this. All the way through.
Legs. Come on. 3, 2, 1. And time.
Double high five. Double high five to you.
Whew. Good job.
All right.
Legs, glutes. Feel that a bit tomorrow. All right. Get some water. We're going to cool it down, though. Let's get down on our backs. Lauren and I will stagger a little bit. And all we're going to do is just lay down and hug one knee in tight. Just hang out right here. So we're getting some glutes involved. If you want, you can actually even reach that knee across your body and get even some more glute involved. The world's your oyster here. But either way, we're just getting that hip flexed. That stretches the glute a little bit. Awesome work. And switch sides.
Now's your chance to also just get your breathing back to normal. Start taking some nice deep breaths. Try to make sure you're not breathing up too high into your neck or tensing your face as you breathe. Try to bring that breath down low into your belly.
And good. Flip over onto all fours. Get your knees out wide on your forearms, chest up tall. We're gonna rock all the way back. Pause here for a couple seconds and then bring it all the way forward. And all the way back. And all the way forward. Good. The wider your knees are, the more you'll feel your hips, inner thighs, glutes working as you go back and forth. Awesome work today. This is a fun one.
It was. Good job. Jason wrote this class.
That's why I said it was fun. When you write classes, it's really uncomfortable and not fun. All right, cool. Let's get into a push-up position. We're gonna get into a calf stretch. So stack one foot on top of the other. You're gonna bring that heel down to the floor and also bring your hips up towards the ceiling, almost like you're doing downward dog, but on one leg. And then you're gonna cycle forward again and then heel down, hips up high. Good. Back and forth. You can also just pause and hold here if you want to go for a static calf stretch and hamstring stretch. All right, let's switch it up. So heel to the ground, press your hips up towards the ceiling, and then cycle back or hang. All right, last one. Stretching out the back of the legs. And we are good. All right. Awesome job. High five.
All right.
Well done. All right.
We never have an outro.
We never have an outro. You know, I was just thinking about high fives. You know, even if we were in person, we would still be doing the same air five right now. So,
pandemic life.
You know, we're basically in person right now. That's how real life this is. But awesome job today. Well done. If you have any questions or topics for future videos, please let us know down below.
Subscribe to our channel and come back and do another one with us again soon.
Yeah, until next time.
Sweat out.
Happiness in.